Welcome back, everyone. My name is Joel Feld, and today I wanted to discuss backing up your iCloud photos. Here we go. I get this question asked a lot in regards to backing up iCloud photos and the best workflows, methods, tools, and I just want to walk you through my method and reasoning for the way I back up my photos from my computer, my iPhone, iPad, all of that, then give you some alternatives and some recommendations of other options that may be helpful. Often iCloud gets confused with backing up and what it backs up, but in the grand scheme of things, if you're using iCloud photos, in theory, it's not necessarily backed up. I did another video that I'll link down below about iCloud backup, but specifically regarding iCloud photos on Apple's website, if you use messages in iCloud or iCloud photos, your content is automatically stored in iCloud, but that means that they're not included in your iCloud backup. So iCloud backup, number one, does not back up your Mac. It does back up your iPhone and iPad, but if you're using iCloud photos, those pictures are not included in the backup. So what that means is when you take a picture on your iPhone, yes, it's going to iCloud and it's saved there as well, and it copies that picture to your Mac, but if you delete a photo on your phone, it deletes it from iCloud and it also deletes it on your Mac because it's more of a syncing service. It's designed to sync and make all of your devices on the same page. With that being said, we also have to define a backup and what it means. And I think it means different things based on the scenario that you're in. So for example, let's say I have my phone here and I'm using iCloud photos. Well, when I take pictures here, they're going up to iCloud and in return going to my computer, my iPad, and my other computer. Now, let's say that hypothetically this phone got lost, stolen, broken, something like that. I don't have this phone anymore. When I get a new phone, all I have to do is sign in with my iCloud account and all of those photos are going to come down from the cloud and they're back on my device. Now, one could say that is a backup, or one could just say that's the convenience of using a cloud solution that also has your files copied in another location. Because the other scenario is I have this phone, my friend has it, or brother, sister, son, daughter, whomever it may be, they go into my phone and they start deleting a whole bunch of pictures. And those pictures, they get put in the recently deleted category for 30 days. After those 30 days, they're gone completely. Now, let's say I don't know that that happened. So 2 months goes by, 3 months, those pictures, because they were in iCloud, they also deleted from iCloud. They also deleted then from my Mac and my iPad and my other computer. So then those pictures are not backed up because it's just designed to sync. My phone is physically fine, but those pictures and content were never actually backed up. They're just part of the cloud system that synchronized it to all of the other devices. So depending on what scenario you're in, if you're using iCloud, sure, it's convenient to get a new one, a new device and sign in, but it's really not a backup. The other alternative is if you don't use iCloud photos and you just have your photographs on your phone and you start taking pictures, they're only physically on here. Well, if you lose or something happens to this phone, where are your photos at? You have to have them someplace else in order for it to be considered a backup. Because the whole purpose of a backup is if something gets accidentally deleted, you're able to recover those files that were accidentally deleted. I want to walk you through what I do and then give you some alternatives for iPhone users, iPad users, and Mac users. Now, specifically for my setup, I synchronize all of my photos to an external hard drive. Because my internal hard drive is not that big, if you don't have enough storage on your internal hard drive, you can actually get an external hard drive like this and put your Apple photo library on here, and then this is where all of your photos actually get stored. The downfall to that is anytime you want to use it, you have to have this plugged in. For me, I'm going to go ahead and plug this into my computer, open it up, this external hard drive, we're going to go right to libraries, right now, because I use iCloud Photos, every picture and video that I take with my phone automatically gets uploaded to iCloud and in return goes to this computer, copied to this computer, and saved to this external hard drive. And it's a very important setting that we want to look at to make sure that it's capturing the highest quality. If I go to Photos in the top left and choose Preferences, first we're going to look at the library location. So the library location is this external hard drive, and this is the system library that's being used. This is the one that's talking to iCloud Photos and my other Mac and my iPhone and my iPad. Now the other option is iCloud here. And so I have iCloud Photos toggled on and I have it set to download the originals to this Mac. That way I know 100% all of the raw high quality original photos live on this external hard drive that I have plugged into my Mac. Now this is all great and everything, but even though it's on an external hard drive, it's not backed up. It just means that those files live on this external hard drive. If I delete something in Apple Photos here, it's still gonna be deleted in iCloud and it's still gonna be deleted from my phone and my iPad. So I have to have a backup solution if that were to happen. And that's where most people get another external hard drive that I use for Time Machine. If you're not familiar with Time Machine is built-in software on the Mac. I'll link a video below that covers that more in detail. So check that out. If you do not have an external hard drive that you use for a backup for your computer, go get one. I highly, highly recommend it. The price point of them has dropped dramatically over the past. It's well worth it to save all of your information. So with this, I'm gonna go ahead and plug this in, because essentially what happens is when I have these two external hard drives plugged in, everything that's on the external hard drive that I plugged in first, this coffee one, the SSD photos, that is automatically being backed up on this backup 6 terabyte here. The benefit of this is the way Time Machine works is Time Machine automatically just keeps on saving. It just keeps on saving and saving and saving and saving. So it's not a two-way sync. So that means that if I go into the photos on here and delete a picture within Apple Photos, those photographs are not being deleted from my external hard drive. So this allows it to be backed up in case something happens. Now there are other alternatives where I could back up my computer, but really you have two different choices, either a physical local backup like this external hard drive or some cloud solution. Now there's lots of cloud solutions out there. I'll link these down below as well. There's a company called Backblaze. Backblaze is highly recommended. I know a lot of users that use it that say it works pretty well. And this gives you options to back up your Mac and your iPhone and your iPad for additional monthly fees, just like iDrive, where they have different price points and different storage options. Google One, they have different price points and options for backing up certain information to their Google Photos. Another option for Microsoft OneDrive, various price points as well. And if you've ever heard of Dropbox, Dropbox is another cloud solution that allows backup. So in the grand scheme of things, all of these cloud providers, they do have some form of backing up your content from a device, Mac, Windows, iPhone, iPad, that kind of stuff. But keep in mind, they're not all created equal. A lot of them are a two-way sync. If I have Google Photos on my phone, it copies those pictures out of the Photos app from Apple and puts them into Google Photos. So they're stored there as well. So if I delete them out of Apple Photos here, they still reside on Google Photos. But then it's another cloud cost that you have to pay for to accommodate for your growing library. So I would recommend to check out what's best for you. I personally like the options of just having a physical hard drive, because then I know I'm not going to get into the concept where they raise their prices like Amazon did recently. So with Amazon Prime, they actually give you unlimited photo storage within their Amazon Prime membership, but they don't do it for video. So if you want to include video, they only give you 5 gigs for free, and then it starts to bump up to a more tiered price structure, just like all of the other ones. So I'll leave this link in the description down below as well, and you can further look at that. Amazon actually works pretty well too for backup of your photos and your computer actually. Either way, get yourself some type of backup, whether it's a physical one or a cloud solution. Cloud is not only the monthly fee, but it also requires an internet connection too. So think about that. Now, let's say that you do not have a Mac computer or any computer in general, and you only have your phone. You can still use the cloud solutions, but what about a physical backup? Well, that's where SanDisk actually makes these nice little tiny flash drives that actually had the Lightning connector on there that plugged directly into your iPhone and iPad, the older iPads. The brand new ones have the new USB-C port on there. And I don't know, maybe SanDisk has an updated flash drive, but these ones here, check them out. I'll link down below. It's really slick. It just plugs right into your phone or your iPad, and you can back up directly to this flash drive. So let's go ahead and plug it in, and I'll show you how that works, because they're actually really slick. Very small, compact. If you don't want to use any cloud solution, if you don't want to use iCloud Photos at all, this is a really, really nice method. And it also has the option to integrate with Google Photos, and it has the option to integrate and back up your contacts and calendars. So we're gonna go ahead and plug this in. And when I plug it in, it's gonna say, iXpand drive, would like to communicate with the SanDisk Expand flash drive. So we're gonna choose allow. Now this is a separate app. If you don't have the app, it'll actually prompt you to download the app. So we'll just take a quick detour. We'll go into the App Store here. And if you do a search for iXpand drive, it is the, it's gonna give us a notification saying, hey, you left the app. So we're just gonna swipe up on that. It's this very first one that you want, the SanDisk iXpand drive. That's what you'd wanna get. Now, if we go ahead and choose open here, down here at the bottom, we have options to copy files, view the files, backup and restore, and then do more store, which just takes you out to their website to sell you more stuff. In the top right, you have a little gear, which allows you to change the name. So I could touch drive name and I could rename this flash drive if I want to, but I'll touch the back button. And notice at the top there, it's automatically backing up my photos because I've told it to. I've already plugged this in and I use it. So it's actually taking all of the photos right now and backing up new ones. I'm gonna touch the arrow back in the left. In the top left, it has a little camera option. So I can actually just go into here and take a picture and it's gonna save it to that flash drive or a video. So let's take a step back. But the thing that I wanna focus on is the backup and restore. So when I touch up backup and restore, it gives you three choices. One is regarding the photo library, one is integrating it into Google Photos, and the other is backup and restore contacts calendars. So if we choose the first one, notice I have a little toggle switch already toggled on for automatic backup, and it's going to back up to a folder called camera roll backup. If I unplug this flash drive, plug it into a computer, we're going to see all of the files that have been copied on there. Now notice there's a lot of pictures that it's trying to back up. Whether you use iCloud Photos or not, you can still use this device. Now I will say that there is a setting for iCloud Photos regarding of how it downloads the photographs, and regardless of how you have it, based off of SanDisk's support website. Actually, let's just go there so I can talk about the settings. We're gonna exit out of the app. We're gonna go into settings, go to iCloud, choose iCloud again, and go to Photos. So for iCloud Photos, there's two different settings: optimize iPhone storage and download and keep originals. Most people will choose optimize iPhone storage or iPad storage, so that way it stores the full high quality photos in iCloud, but keeps a lower quality thumbnail on your phone, so you're still able to see all of the pictures and videos on there. And when you're in the photos, if you touch it, then it downloads the original. Now, this little adapter, this flash drive, will download all of them for you. So if you have it set to optimize iPhone storage, it will go out to iCloud and prompt it to download the full quality, so it's saved. So that just means that it's going to, number one, take longer, based off of your internet connection. And you just wanna make sure that you have enough storage on here to accommodate all of those files. So for me, I have way more than 128 gigs in iCloud Photos. So this method would never back up all of my photos. This is why I use a Time Machine Backup, because it's much, much larger. So for other alternatives for my phone or my iPad, I would have to get a larger flash drive or just use a second or a third one to make sure all of my files are backed up, or pictures, I should say. So let's go back into the iXpand app. So iXpand drive, here we go, and it's still backing up those photos. I can touch the arrow on the top left and choose backup and restore contacts, and I could toggle that on. I could touch calendar and toggle that on also. I don't necessarily back those up. I back those up in Time Machine as well as iCloud. So I'm not too concerned about those, but honestly, they don't take up very much space. So it's really not a bad idea to do that anyways. Now the backup Google Photos, this will integrate into your Google Photos account. So when I touch this, it's going to prompt you to sign in, and that's where it would link and then start using that cloud storage that you're paying for Google. So again, whenever you get into any of the cloud solutions, there's always some additional cost for it. So I'm gonna touch the arrow on the back left and go back to the main menu. and here we are. I can also view this flash drive in files on the phone. So if I exit out of here and go into the files app, which if you're not familiar with files, I'll link another video down below that I did that is actually extremely helpful, that really talks more so about iCloud Drive and just how to manage your files within files and iCloud Drive in general. But when I go into files on here, it does give me the option to show this flash drive, but when I touch it, it just goes directly to the interface of that app rather than using the actual files app. So we'll exit out of files and we'll go back to the iXpand, and it's just continuing to copy across the top. Now with this, there's no eject button, there's nothing like that. So I can actually just go ahead and unplug this, and then I can plug this directly into my computer. So if we do that, it will launch and show up on my desktop. So if I double click on this, it will show me everything for the calendar backup, contacts. Now those photos were saved in the camera roll backup, and what's nice is it's gonna automatically organize it for me based off of date and month. So if I went to 2021, it's actually gonna show me every single month and all of the photos that are in there. So this gives me options to know that all of my files are safe and sound on this flash drive if something were to happen to my phone. You can actually have video files on there, you can have music files. So it is a very, very nice little flash drive that works pretty well with your iPhone and iPad. So we're just gonna close this out and we'll eject this disconnect from the computer. So overall, that is how I back up my iCloud photos. I had the benefit of having an external hard drive, so it downloads everything and go to a Time Machine backup. But also, if I didn't have that, these little flash drives are a huge saver. Some of the cloud options out there work really, really well. But again, just keep in mind, do what works best for you, and just know that if you're using any of the additional cloud stuff, it's just going to be an extra monthly cost for you. So that is backing up your iCloud photos. I hope it was helpful and gave you some things to think about. I hope you do have a backup. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked what you saw, go ahead and hit that like button. If you learned something and you want to learn more, hit that subscribe button, tap that little bell, and we'll see you next time.